नियतिकृत नियमरहितां ख्लादैकमयीं अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आददति भारती कवेर्जयति. फिनिश्ड् अर्थान्तर्न्यासालङ्कार. वि हेव् टु स्टार्ट् वित् विरोध. विरोधः सः अविरोधे अपि विरुद्धत्वेन यद्वचः. सो वस्तुवृत्तेन अविरोधे अपि विरुद्धयोः इव यद् अविधानं सः विरोधः. दिस् अलङ्कार इस् आल्सो काल्ड् विरोधाभास अलङ्कार. यु विल् फैण्ड् अ लाट् आफ् दिस् अलङ्कार. दिस् अलङ्कार इस् यूस्ड् ए लाट् बै बाण इन् हिस् कादम्बरि. एनी डिस्क्रिप्शन् विल् आल्वेस् एण्ड् वित् अ कपल् आफ् विरोध फर् हिम्. इट् इस् लैक् हिस् फेवरेट् अलङ्कारं फर् हिम्. सो विरोधः सः दट् द अलङ्कार विरोध इस् वेर् अविरोधे अपि. When there are two objects which do not have any virodham, yet at the same time, not object, so he is going to show that the virodham can exist in four things. So where there is no virodham, the Kavi is trying to show an apparent contradiction between the two things. So there, and then of course, the virodha also gets negated. The virodha parihara also happens. Because of our understanding of the situation. So how we understand and how that virodha pariharam is done is based on the sahrudaya, not on the kavi, because the kavi will not describe how the virodha pariharam is done, that the contradiction is removed. So here vastuvrittena ityukte vastavikatah avirodhe api. There is no actual, in reality there is no contradiction yet. विरुद्धयोः इव यत् अभिधानं विरुद्धत्वेन यद्वचः. इट् इस् एन् एक्स्प्लेनेशन् फार् देट् पार्ट् आफ् द कारिका. सो विरुद्धत्वेन एस् इफ् देर् इस् अ कान्ट्रडिक्षन् इट् इस् बीङ्ग् डिस्क्रैब्ड् लैक् देट्. सो यत् अभिधानं सः विरोधः. जातिः चतुर्भिः जात्याद्यैः विरुद्धा स्यात् गुणः स्यात् गुणः त्रिभिः क्रिया द्वाभ्यामपि द्रव्यं द्रव्येण एव इति ते दश. देर् आर् टेन् टैप्स् आफ् विरोधालङ्कार एण्ड् हि इस् गोयिङ्ग् टु गिव् एन् एक्साम्पल् फार् ईच् वन् आफ़् दोस्. सो वि विल् हेव् टेन् वेरैटीस् हियर्. ऐल् ट्रै टु डू फैव् टुडे एण्ड् मे बि फैव् नेक्स्ट् क्लास्. Virodha, this is also called Virodhabhasa Alankara, just I said. So what are the four things? Jati, Guna, Kriya, Dravyam. So Jatihi is the particular samanyam that we say. When I say kavya prakashaha, it is a particular one, visheshaha. If I say sahitya shastram, then it is a samanyam. It is more to do with the genus, in general. So that is one. Gunaha is a quality, kriya an action, dravyam is that particular object. So how jati जातेः जात्या विरुद्धः इस् द फस्ट् वेरैटि. जातेः गुणेन सह विरोधः, जातेः क्रियया सह विरोधः, जातेः द्रव्येण सह विरोधः. फस्ट् इस् फोर् टैप्स्. सिन्स् वी हव् आल्रेडि हेड् गुणस्य जात्या सह विरोधः हेस् आल्रेडि बीन् मेन्शन्ड् इन् द फस्ट्. वि गो टु द गो फ्रम् गुणेन गुणस्य विरोधः, गुणस्य क्रियया सह विरोधः, गुणस्य द्रव्येण सह विरोधः. देट् इस् टोटलि सेवेन् नौ. क्रियायाः क्रियया सह विरोधः एण्ड् देन् क्रियायाः द्रव्येण सह विरोधः. यु हेव् टु मोर् देर् विच् इस् नैन् एण्ड् द लास्ट् वन् इस् द्रव्यस्य द्रव्येण सह विरोधः. हि विल् गिव् डेफिनेशन्स् फार् ईच् आफ् दिस्. वन्स् दि एक्साम्पल्स् वि गो थ्रू अ कपल् आफ़् एक्साम्पल्स् यु विल् अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् ईवन् वित् द फस्ट् वन् आर् मे बि द सेकेण्ड् you'll get a hang of what the virodham is and how it goes. Kramena udaharanam abhinava nalini kisalaya mrinala valayadi dava dahana rashihi subhaga kuranga drishoho asyaha vidhi vashatah tvadviyoga pavi pate. Tvadviyoga pavi pate asya he subhaga fortunate one. Maybe a sakhi is talking to the Nayaka, who she wants to reveal the Nayika's virahavastha to him and say, you know, viraham, she's undergoing separation, love and separation, so you have to, you know, take care. In some way, she has to convey that to her, to the Nayaka. Subhaga asyaha kurangadrishaha, this lady's vidhivashataha tvadviyoga pavipate sati, sati when she is separated from you. Now, how is he describing that separation? Tvad viyoga, viyogaha eva pavipataha, pavi vajra, vajrapataha. So, tvad viyogaha eva vajrapata samam asti. So, as she is, when she experiences this vajrapatam in the form of your viyoga, your separation, asyaha kuranga drishaha, this happens because of fate. Why is she separated? Vidhivashataha, because of fate. She is experiencing this vajrapatam, that is your separated, being separated from you. So what is the result? As a result of that, because she is separated, in Kavyam we have seen that they use the jvara, tapaha increases in the body and the heat increases. So in order to cool down the body, you use a lot of cooling effects like abhinava, nalini, kisalaya, mrinala, valayadi. She tries to cool her body with all these things. Abhinava, fresh, nalini, lotus, kisalaya, flowers or leaves, mrinala, valayadi. I made a mistake there. So, okay. Bracelets made of mrinalam, lotus stalks. All of these things are supposed to have a cooling effect. But what happens? Etat sarvam davana dahana rashihi bhavati. It becomes like a heap of fire, dahanam. Fire, dava is also forest fire. So it is like a forest fire. So a forest, idea of forest fire is it quickly spreads over. So it cannot be removed very quickly, right? So that is why he compares it with a forest fire. So dava dahana rashihi bhavati. So here, nalini, kisalaya, mrinala, valayam, all of these are supposed to contribute shitalatvam, but it only contributes ushnatvam. He does not mention the gunam here. He only mentions the jati, which is nalini, nalinitva. The jati is supposed to have shitalatvam. That is what we understand from the whole shlokam. But here he just says the nalini has become davadahanam. Any nalini that she uses, any lotus leaves that she uses has actually become like a dahana rashi. It's become like a heap of it's an apparent contradiction in the sense a lotus flower or lotus flowers in general cannot become fire. But here, that contradiction is removed if we think of it in terms of viraham. Because her separation has increased, anything that is cool does not give her that coolness, that shitalatva guna yukta jati, any item. So that is why it is a common thing that he says and not dravyam. So it becomes like a forest fire for her because of the viraha. So everything is a viraha uddipakam for her. Okay, so here it is jatehe jatyasaha virodha. This virodha pariharam is something we understand. Again, it is not given by the poet. We understand it as a viraha uddipaka. Next is jatya. If you remember in the table, it is jatya jatehe gunena saha virodha. That is your second type. Girayopi anunnati yujo. It will be more clear with this. Marudapi achalaha. Abdhayaha api agambiraha vishvambhara api atilaguhu naranatha tava antike niyatam. A poet is addressing a king and saying, hey naranatha, tava antike, in front of you or in your presence. Girayaha api anunnati yujaha, unnati yuktaha na santi, anunnati yujaha. They do not, even mountains are not so tall in your presence. Because the king is very unnati. Unnatam here is not about physical tall. Unnati also is progress. So he is playing on the meaning of that word, unnati, and saying that. So girayaha api anunnati yujaha. Even mountains are not tall in your presence. Marudapi achalaha na chalati. Marut is supposed to be constantly moving around, right? So, in Nyaya Shastra, this is Sarvagatiman Vayu. He is constantly moving. Marut, the air is constantly moving. But here, the wind also seems motionless Because you seem to be more active than the wind. In front of you, the wind is also not so active. Abdhayaha api agambiraha. Even oceans are not as deep because you are more, you have more gambhiratvam than the oceans. In your presence, the oceans do not seem deep. Vishvambara api ati laguhu. Even the earth seems very small. You have spread your rule so much that it seems as if you are ruling the entire earth as one country or one city. So the earth itself seems very small. You have so much of udara gunattam. So in your presence, the earth seems very small. Here, jati is the giritva jati. Any mountain is supposed to be unnataha. So parvataha unnataha girihi unnataha. So unnatatva gunaha sarvada girau vartate. That you cannot remove it, but he is showing in a contradiction saying that girihi api na unnataha. So giritva jatihi anunnati guna yukta. So he is saying everything for that matter. Marut is always chalaha. But he is saying achalatva guna yuktaha. So there seems to be an apparent contradiction. It is not actually that the vayu is not at all moving and it is just stand still. In relative, so when we are going in a train, we see the row of trees just running past us because we are stationary inside a train. The train is moving. It is that relative motion that we talk about. So here also something very similar where in comparison, in the presence of the king, it seems very small. Otherwise, it is not small. Physically, it is quite tall and the vayu is constantly moving. Oceans are quite deep and the earth is quite huge. Vipalacha prithvi. Okay, so how this contradiction can be removed is when we try to explain Varnaniya Nripasya Aunnatya Atishayaha, because he wants to highlight the Aunnatyam or the Gambhiryam or Chalatvam, let's say Utsaha Shakti Yuktaha Saha and Udara Gunaha, Atva, you can say Mahan, Mahatvam. These are all in are exemplary. How do I say? These are the excelling qualities that are there in the king. In order to explain that excellence of qualities, he uses this virodham to do that. So jatehe gunena saha virodha. The next one. Now you get the idea of virodha and parihara. It'll be very useful if you start reading Kadambari and the descriptions that are there. Now it will become more clear when you read Kadambari. Or rather, Kadambari will become more clear after doing this, I guess. So, yesham kantha parigraha pranayitam samprapya dharadharaha tikshnaso api anurajyate nakamapi sneham parapnoti cha tesham sangara sanga sakta manasam rajnyam tvaya bhupate pamsunam patale prasadhana vidhi nirvartyate kautukam. Very nice image in this shlokam. Again, the kavi is addressing a king. He Bhupate, tava dharadharaha tikshnaha asti. Your sword, dharadharaha, dhara is a sharp edge. And that weapon which has a sharp edge is called dharadharaha khadgaha. So your sword is extremely sharp, tikshnaha asti, so api yesham kantha parigraha pranayitam samprapya, so api anurajyate kamapi sneham parapnoti cha. He is imagining it like naika bhava between the sword and the necks of the shatru kings, enemy kings. So when the sword comes in contact with the shatru kings, it just stays there and it becomes sneham. There is an attachment to the sword with the enemy kantha. Sneham parapnoti, anurajyate, it enjoys a lot, and sneham api prapnoti. Here actually he uses that anurajyate, you can see as I describe that there is a contradiction between khadgaha and anurajyate, anuranjana kriya and sneha prapti kriya. Both of these have a problem. What does that mean? Anurajyate also means, it not only means enjoy, it also means ranjanam means coloring. So anuranjanam here indicates rudhira, rudhirena krita laughityam. It becomes completely red because of the blood from the enemies. Sneham is that we say chikkanam because it is adena pisipisip abrimbo tamil. We call it snigdhatvam. So it becomes very sticky like oil. So rudhiram is not like water which just runs away. Rudhiram is more a sticky substance. So he uses slesha here to give that idea of virodham. This is the exact type that Bana uses in Kadambari a lot. So tikshnaha dharadharaha so api yesham rajnyam kantagraha. So when a nayaka embraces a nayika, kantagraha pa kanta parigraha is an embrace. Pranayitam samprapya, when it becomes a beloved and embraces the beloved, at that point anurajyate, a nayika always enjoys that moment and sneham parapnoti, parapnoti param apnoti, and it also she also gets attached to the nayaka a lot because of that kantagraha. He uses that to compare with the or that image comes to our mind. So tesham rajnyam shatru rajnyam sangara sanga sakta manasam rajnyam prasadana vidhihi bhupate tvaya kriyate tvaya nirvartyate. See here, prasadana vidhihi means like makeup. So you are actually, it seems like you are performing makeup with the pamsu patalam, with dust. So for the makeup, you first use powder and all that, right? So here, first, imagine the scene where the king uses his sword to cut the enemy's necks and they fall down. When they fall down, their faces are covered by dust. So this is how the image is. What the poet imagines it to be is when the sword hits the neck of the kings, you perform like a makeup. Prasadhana vidhihi means you are doing makeup for those kings with the pamsu unam patalaihi, with the pamsu of dust, heaps of dust. And the adjective visheshanam for rajnyam is sangara sanga sakta manasa. Their minds are constantly sakta, attached to sangara sanga, they sangaraha yuddham. They want to be in the yuddham only, and even though they want to keep on fighting, yet you, O king, you are more powerful than those enemy kings, and you kill them, and it's like as if you are doing makeup with the heaps of dust. Right? So which means they fall down. Kautukam here, the word is with kautukam nirvartyate. You can say with a curiosity or something like that. Let me just check what the vyakhyata says for this. I missed out on that word. Kautukam iti aascharyam. Sorry. Okay. So generally, kautukam also means curiosity. So here, he just uses it as a kriya visheshanam. Athava, you can say, iti etat sarvam aascharyam eva. Alankarana vidihi karoti iti. So you can say that. Kantam chitva sangrama dhuli dusaraha kriyante. Iti etat kautukam aascharyam. Okay. Now, how does the lakshana samanvayam come? Alankarasya lakshanasya samanvayaha kartavyaha. So jatehe kriyayasaha virodhaha. Jati here would be dharadharatva jati, which is khadgatva jati. Khadgam, the sword, does not have a kriya of, or it is contradicting with the kriya of anuranjanam and sneha prapti. So instead of that, we take the other meaning, slesha, and we take the other meaning of rudhirena lohiti karanam or chikkanatvam for sneha prapti. Sneha also means snigdhatvam. It also means that thick attachment. And this is precisely what he will use bana with this, you know, balandhakara api tejav pravrtihi. बालान्धकार अपि बाल अन्धकार अपि ईवन् दो देर् इस् डार्क्नेस् येट् देर् इस् तेजः सो यु यूस् दट् बाल एण्ड् अन्धकार the word bala does not mean young it also means hair so keshasya andhakara sattve api mukhasya tejas sattvam iti virodha pariharaha so that one of the examples that I can just remember off the top of my head the next one is jatehe dravyena saha virodhah srijati cha jagat idam avati cha samharati cha helayeiva yo niyatam अवसरवशतः शफरो जनार्दनः सोऽपि चित्रमिदम् जनार्दनः विष्णुः सृज जगत् इदम् इदं जगत् सृजति सो वन् हु क्रियेट्स् दिस् वर्ल्ड् प्रोटेक्ट्स् अवति प्रोटेक्ट्स् संहरति डिस्ट्राय्स् हेलया एव से वि आल्वेस् से दट् सृजति इति ब्रह्मा डस् दिस् सृष्टिकार्यम् Vishnu does the paripalanam and Shiva does the samharanam. If you take the Vaishnava sampradaya, all of these are Ishvara Tattvam and the Paravasudevan is your ultimate reality for them. Right? Even for Advaitins, it is the Brahma Tattvam that is behind these Ishvara Tattvam. So that Paravasudevan, Janardhanaha, Yaha, Srijati, he is responsible for Srishti also. The avati for the paripalanam srishti sthiti and then layam samharanam nashaha he is responsible for that also so one who creates protects and destroys this world helaya eva helaya is leelaya sattavo tatpita bahusyam prajayeyeti it is just one leela for him he just thought and then he created this entire world सो लीलया एव यः एवं सर्वम् अकरोत् इदं जगत् सृजति अवति संहरति च नियतं वाट् हि डेफिनेट्लि डस् रैट् बट् इट् इस् इण्डीड् सर्प्रैस् दट् अवसरतः अवसरवशतः अवसरवशतः बिकास् औट् आफ् नेसेसिटि अवसरम् आर् द सिचुवेशन् प्राम्प्टेड् हिम् टु टेक् द फार्म् आफ् अ शफरः शफरः मीनः मत्स्यः The situation demanded that he took the form of a meena. So here, a person who is capable of so many great things in this world, like creating the entire world or protecting it, and because of which, yena jatani jeevanti, yat prayanti abhisambhishanti. So one who is responsible for the creation, sthiti and layam, It is a surprising thing that he could take the form of a matsya. He actually takes the form of a small fish in the hands of that rishi. Right? So, avasara vashataha, because of the situation, avasara is opportunity, because of some opportunity or situation that demands, shabaraha abhut iti chitramidam. It's indeed surprising that such a great form like janardhanaha can take the form of a shabhara. Here, jati is shaparatva jati and janardhanaha is one particular person. There is no janardhanatvam jati here. Ishwaratvam can be a jati because there are different types of Ishwara. But there is only one janardhana according to one siddhanta. So which is, you cannot have a jati there. So he becomes the dravyam. There is only one person. Right? So, jatehe, shaparatva jatehe, janardana rupa dravyasya virodaha. How? Because janardana is capable of doing all of these actions, whereas this shaparam, this meenam, does not, the word meena itself, it cannot live even without that water. How can it be capable of producing so many things in this world? So, that virodha pariharam is agamasiddham. See, he taking an avataram of matsyavatara is agamasiddhatvam and he does not stop with being a small matsyam. If you know how it grows within a day, it takes a huge form. It's an avatara. And leelaya, if he can create all of these, leelaya, he can take an avataram also. That is the greatness of mahima. That is the Ishvara mahima. सो ईश्वरमहिम्नः एतत् सर्वं साध्यम् इति विरोधपरिहारोऽपि क्रियते Next is gunasya. Now, the four contradictions of jati we have finished, virodha. So, jatehe jatya saha virodha, jatehe gunena saha, jatehe kriyaya saha, jatehe dravyena saha virodha. Now, we move on to gunam. Okay, we'll do one of those. Satatam musalasakta bahutara grihakarma ghatanaya nripate. द्विजपत्नीनां कठिनाः सति भवति कराः सरोजसुकुमाराः. दिस् इस् अगेन् कवि इस् डिस्क्रैबिङ्ग् द चारिटबल् नेचर् आफ् अ किङ्ग्. सो अ किङ्ग् हू गिव्स् दानं अ लाट्, दानशीलः कोऽपि राजा, तस्य वर्णना इयं श्लोकम् सततं मुसलासक्ता बहुतरगृहकर्मघटनया. हे नृपते, there are these brahmin ladies, dvijapatninam karaha. He is describing the hands of ladies, especially brahmin ladies, who are very used to doing hard housework. Bahutara grihakarma ghatanaya, because of doing too much of housework with those hands, those hands which are musala asakta, it is constantly connected, asaktam, it is constant, always having that musalam. Musalam na na olakka, I don't know the English word for this. How do I say this? It is mortar and pestle, the big one, the pestle, that stick with which you hit and make dough, right? Mava, that is called pestle. So the big one is called musalam. Musala asaktaha karaha, dvijapatninam karaha, katinaha sati, when they are supposed to be katinam, you get calloused hands when you keep holding something which is very hard and you try to keep doing that continuously, then you will have all calloused hands here. So katinaha sati, now how are they? सरोज सुकुमाराः भवन्ति. सततं कठिनाः तव सति नृपते सरोज सुकुमाराः भवति कठिनाः. नो नो, सति, ऐ थिङ्क् ऐ एम् मिस्टेकिङ्ग् दट् वर्ड्. भवति सतीन् वर्णमो, मै अन्वयम् इस् आफ् हियर्, वन् मिनिट्. हे नृपते, सततं मुसलेषु आसक्ताः बहुतर गृहकर्म घटनया सम्पादनेन कठिनाः कराः, सारी, भवति दातरी सति, दट् सती गोस् देर्. हे नृपते, भवति दातरी सति सरोजकोमलाः भवन्ति आर् जाताः. यु जस्ट् टेक् दट्. सो हियर् भवति बिकम्स् भवान् भवच्छब्दस्य सप्तमी. Okay, twayi datari sati, when you are giving gifts to all these brahmins, now they have so much of wealth, they don't need to slog around with all these doing hard housework. For it to become saroja sukumaraha, saroja sukumara means it becomes very soft like lotus, their hands have become very soft like lotus. For it to become soft, callous hands to turn into soft hands, imagine for how long the king should have given money for them and how he is continuously giving them. So, tvai datari sati, griha karma eva na kurvanti. They do not do any housework and they've stopped doing their housework for a long time. So, their hands which are kathinaha have now become saroja sukumaraha. Karaha. Karaha is your object which is supposed to have kathinatva gunam, and that guna, if it has kathinatvam, it cannot have sukumaratvam. It is contradicting here, right? How can you say it is kathinam here, it is soft here? You can't have two viruddha quality, viruddha gunanam ekasminneva adhikarane sattvam na shakyam. So that is a virodha, but it is only an apparent virodha. which was Katinam before. Now the king has given so much of wealth to them that it has become Saroja, Saroja Sukumaram, Sarojavati Saukumaryam Atra Karayoho Vidyate. Right? So that is the Virodha Pariharam. We will stop with this, and the next five I will do in the next class.